This is Psalm 111. Praise ye the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart, in the assembly of the upright and in the congregation. The works of the Lord are great, sought out of all them that have pleasure therein. His work is honorable and glorious, and his righteousness endureth forever. He hath made his wonderful works to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion. He hath given meat unto them that fear him. He will ever be mindful of his covenant. He hath showed his people the power of his works, that he may give them the heritage of the heathen. The works of his hands are verity and judgment. All his commandments are sure. They stand fast forever and ever, and are done in truth and uprightness. He sent redemption unto his people. He hath commanded his covenant forever. Holy and reverend is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all they that do his commandments. His praise endureth forever.
Welcome, all of you, as fellow believers, to the special Thanksgiving praise and prayer service. Our sole purpose tonight is to praise and to thank God for who he is and for what he has done for us, his children. Tonight, during prayer meeting, we are not going to focus on requests. We're not going to focus on petitions, supplications, intercessions, or other forms of asking God for things. Our focus tonight is just going to be on praising and thanking him. Psalm 111, just read by Micah, is one of the hallelujah psalms. What we're going to do tonight is, as we go through the service, there's going to be three parts that are going to take place in various sequences. There's going to be scripture reading done by our youth. We appreciate their ministry in that respect. Because there's so many other times in the service that we're going to be standing, we're not going to stand every time a scripture is read. Okay? We're going to remain seated unless told to stand. The second part is we're going to sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. That kind of sounds biblical, doesn't it? All right? We're going to sing those in praise to our Lord. Some of these songs you may know, some you may not know, and you're going to learn today. But all of it is to focus on the words of those psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. All our focus needs to be on what they're saying, not the beautiful music, on what's being said. The third part, we're going to have some specific prayers by some of the leaders of our church that I'm going to ask to pray about specific topics. And their prayers are all going to be praise and thanks. And so you have a program and you can kind of follow it along. You know, we're in a world today that's very PC, politically correct. And we're in that environment. The story is told of a teacher who was having her fourth grade class give reports on the American holiday. And she said to make sure the reports were accurate and politically correct. And so one boy was asked to give his report on the origins of Thanksgiving holiday. And he wrote the following. The pilgrims came here seeking freedom of you know what. When they landed, they gave thanks to you know who. And because of them, we can worship each Sunday, you know where. That's a pretty good report. He said an awful lot. And that's what this service is about. It's about God and the freedom that we have in this country to worship Him, even on a Wednesday night, the day night before Thanksgiving, and that we can worship Him together and sing praise to His name. That's what we want to do. Now, my Sunday school class knows I get pretty fired up on Sundays. Okay? Why? Because I love the Lord. And I know you love the Lord. Let's sing with our whole hearts. Psalm 111 and verse 1 told us the following. Praise the Lord. Praise Yahweh. Praise the Lord essentially said, hallelujah. That's what it said. Hallelujah. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart. God, what does He say in Revelation about half-heartedness? Spew it out. Let's praise the Lord with our whole hearts tonight. In the assembly of the upright or the righteous and in the congregation, we want undivided affections for Jehovah. That's what we want tonight. I'm purposely not emphasizing who's giving different parts of the service because the focus all needs to be on Him. So, let's turn to the first part of the service. In a moment here, Gorman's going to come and lead us in a hymn together. And following that hymn, on the screen, there's going to be a video that is going to be entitled, With a Thankful Heart. Listen to the words of this video. They challenged my heart with a thankful heart. And ask yourself this question. Do I have that kind of thankful heart? Apply it right here. Not does somebody else in the audience have it. Do I have that kind of thankful heart? And then after that video is shown, I'll be up here to talk to you about verse 2 of our song. So, Gorman, if you'll come at this time.
I would like to read from Psalms 34, 1 to 3. 34, 1 to 3. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt His name together. We invite you now to take your hymn books, and we're turning to hymn number 31. And we're going to sing this out, We Gather Together to Ask the Lord's Blessings, number 31 in your hymn books. Standing as we sing, sing it out now very loudly.
Thank you. with a thankful heart and a song of praise. We've come to you, gathered in this place, for the things you've done and for who you are. We worship you with a thankful heart, with a thankful heart and a song of praise. We've come to you, gathered in this place, for the things you've done and for who you are. We worship you with a thankful heart.
So we lift up.
So we lift up our praise, and we lift up our sacrifice to you. Lord, we offer our prayers, and we offer our lives in gratitude. For all you do, we worship you. With a thankful heart, with a thankful heart, we will give you praise. You've been so good, covered us with grace. You have been our strength in a time so dark. So we worship you with a thankful heart.
So we lift up our praise.
We lift up our praise, and we lift up our sacrifice to you. Lord, we offer our prayers, and we offer our lives in gratitude.
We lift up our praise.
We lift up our praise. Lift up our sacrifice to you. Lord, we offer our prayers, and we offer our lives in gratitude. For all you do, we worship you with a thankful heart. We worship you with a thankful heart. Oh, we give you thanks. Oh, we worship you. Oh, we worship you. Oh, we worship you. Oh, we worship you.
Psalm 111, verse 2 tells us, the works of the Lord are great. You know, I feel real sorry for an atheist. How horrible it must be when he or she feels grateful that they have no one to thank. We have a God whose works are great. Do you believe it? They're great. You know, his works are great in number. His works are great in magnitude. His works are great in wisdom. His works are great in goodness. His works are great in variety. The more we observe his works, the more will delight in him. Think about that. The more we observe his works, we remind ourselves of them, the more we will delight in him and his works. His works are sought out of all them that have pleasure therein. Has God ever given you pleasure through what he's done in your life? He has in my life. I'm sure he has in your life. Because we have a faithful God. Yes. We have a God that will never leave us nor what? Yes. Amen. Never. Great are his works. I'm going to ask John to come up now and to the mic over here and pray a prayer of thanks and praise to God for who he is and for his word that tells us about who he is. John, would you lead us in prayer?
Pray. You can pray with your eyes open, you can pray with your eyes closed, but just remember one thing. God sees each and every one of us sitting right here where we're sitting now, and he knows this service is to give thanks unto him. You know, I carry a lot of baggage in my life. You know, I've been through some things that most people never went through, but God got me through it. I didn't know how. I didn't know why. I didn't know where. But God brought me through it. When he called me to go to Altoona Bible Institute, I didn't know I'd have to preach. But God got me through it. Wait on the Lord, it says. How many of us wait on the Lord? We want things right now. But our God is so great that he'll give us what we need, not what we want. We got to remember that. We come to him with all these wants. It's not what you want. It's what you need. That's how great our God is. Do you thank him when you wake up in the morning? You got a breath of air. Your heart's still pumping. You know, you're able to get up and walk. You're able to do all sorts of things. You're able to go outside and enjoy the beauty of the trees, the green grass. I love it living where the change of seasons are. And God put me here. He put me in the state of Pennsylvania. He put me in the greatest country in the world, as far as I'm concerned, the United States of America. It was all God. I didn't have nothing to do with it. Yeah. He could have put me in a Muslim country. He could have put me in Russia. Do you ever thank God for that? Just think of where God can put you in all the nations of the world. But he put you here because he loved you. Because he wanted to see you grow up in the nurture and the admonition of the Lord. And that's what we all got to do. I'm still learning. I'll be 79 years old here in a couple months. I've outlived my dad by 2 years. I've outlived my uncles by a couple years. But I'm still here. I'm still kicking. And I'm still learning. And I learn each and every day. You got to appreciate. You got to thank God for what he did for you. You know, we have God in three essences. God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And each one of them is active. If you'll just ask him. If you'll just bow the knee of your heart and say, Heavenly Father, I need you. I need to come to you. I know there's people sitting in here that's maybe not even saved, never truly trusted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. But you got to bow the knee of that heart. You know, we're full of pride because we're Americans. Well, I'm full of pride. I served my country. You know, I've been down so deep that that I had to sign a paper that I forgot how deep our submarine was.
Yeah.
But I did it, and God got me through it. I lost a friend, not a close friend, but I lost a friend on the USS Scorpion that was coming back from a patrol in the Mediterranean. All right? They closed the sub base down. We have phones all across the Atlantic, sonar phones where they can listen. And all that they heard was a bang. And the Scorpion went to the bottom. I had a friend on there. That could have been me, you know, but it wasn't. We didn't have a chaplain on our submarine, you know, and I wasn't walking with the Lord then, but I was in church, but we had our weapons officer, Lieutenant Tomaszek from Wisconsin. He held the service.
Yeah.
Just think of how great God is. God knew I was down in that submarine, and he brought me through it. I shake, you know, sometimes because of the medication I got to take. I've talked to psychiatrists. I've talked to psychologists. You know, I've talked to them all. I'm on the lowest dose of medicine they can give me, but God brings me through it. One of these days, I'm going to arrive in glory, and I'm no longer going to shake. I'm no longer going to have any scars on my body from things I did. Okay? But God did it. To strengthen me, to make me who I am today, to make me be the man I am today. I drive 82 miles every single day to preach to the truck drivers because I love truck drivers. I was a truck driver. Okay, we were considered the trash of the world, boy. Yeah. What do we know? Yeah. Yeah. I love truck drivers, and I'm proud to be in the ministry where I'm serving. And God did that. Nobody else did that. God kept opening the door. And you young people, when he opens a door, you make sure you walk through it. And you serve him to the best of your ability. Because that's what God wants. He's a God of forgiveness. He'll forgive you so many times. He's forgiven me so many times for things I've done. But he's a great God. We sing that song, How Great Thou Art. Do you mean it? Do you understand how great God is? Do you really understand how great he is? Well, he'll take somebody like me and lift me from the pit of hell and put me to serve him. Thank you.
Thanks unto the Lord, call upon his name, make known his deeds among the people. Sing unto him, sing songs unto him, talk ye of all his wondrous works. Glory ye in his holy name, let the heart of them rejoice that seek the Lord. Seek the Lord in his strength, seek his face continually. Remember his marvelous works that he hath done, his wonders in the judgments of his mouth.
From the book of Psalms, Psalm 69, verse 30, these words, I will praise the name of God with a song and will magnify him with thanksgiving. We invite you to take your hymn books once again and turn to number 10. There's a piano against the place. Stand and sing this song out. Now, thank we all our God. Thank it out, praise it out because of what God has done for us. Now thank we our God with hearts and voices who wondrous things have done in whom his word rejoices who from our mother's arm hath blessed us in our way with countless gifts of love and still is our today. Oh, may this power
13, 5, and 6 say, "But I have trusted in thy mercy. My heart shall rejoice in thy salvation. I will sing unto the Lord because he hath dealt bountiful with me." And now I will be reading 1 Corinthians 15, 57. And that says, "But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ."
Psalm 111, verses 3 and 4. His work is honorable and glorious, and his righteousness endureth forever. He hath made his wonderful works to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion. His work is honorable. That word means splendid or beautiful. Splendid, beautiful work. And glorious, majestic. His work is majestic. His righteousness, his justice, he's a just God, endureth forever. His works bring glory to God from all those that experience them. He hath made his wonderful works to be remembered. Don't ever forget what God has done. Regularly, we have the Lord's table. Why do we do that? In what?
Remembrance
of him. The children of Israel set up memorials to keep in mind, to remember the works of the Lord. We need to do it in our lives. We need to do it corporately at the Lord's table. We need to do it personally in our own homes.
Yes.
Remember what God has done for us. God is so, so faithful. You know, the most precious and significant thing that he did for us? He gave his son, Jesus Christ, so that we, undeserving, can have eternal. Can have salvation. It almost makes me want to break out. And I think we will. Sing it together with me. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Dave's going to come and he's going to lead us in a prayer of thanks and praise. You want to do it again, huh, Tom? Huh? Just one more time? All right. Our service may go over a few minutes here, but we're going to do it. We're not worried about time like that, are we? We'll be done before midnight. All right. Yeah, that's right. That's right. All right. Come on up here and help me lead it, Tom. Come on, brother. Come on. I know you never planning on this. Come on, right up here. Right here, brother. Let's start it off. Here we go.
Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul.
Let us bow our heads. Father, we come before you this evening just, as we always say, giving you thanks and praise. For without your Son, Jesus Christ, we, as the Scriptures say, would be most miserable. Most miserable. I feel sorry for that atheist, too, that doesn't trust in Christ. But all he has to do is realize that he needs a Savior, Lord. That Savior, Jesus Christ, will lead him to victory over death and misery, just as he did this poor old soul standing before you. I'm not worth one iota to have such a wonderful blessing, but yet he loved me as he loved anyone who would accept him. It doesn't matter. He loves all. And when he gave his Son Jesus just for that purpose, and his magnificent glory and his way sitting there in heaven, just knowing that he'd have to give his Son in such a agonizing, painful, miserable, almost unspeakable way to die, Lord, just for me, just for you, just for that atheist, just for that Muslim, just for that person just hurting in heart, knowing that there is some way to get some relief from their miseries, Lord. And Lord, it's more than that. It's that relationship with you. Oh, your great, great ways of showing us that you wanted us to for companionship, Lord. You wanted to be with us. You wanted to socialize with us, Lord. And we thank you for that. And there's only one way to do that. One way, through Jesus Christ, your Son. How great and rich is that salvation you've given us, Lord. The day you entered in my life, I could have barrel rolled right down these front aisles, Lord. Nothing could have held me back for accepting you as my Savior, and I'm awful glad I did. I'm nothing special, but Lord, yet you still love me. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. Thank you for Jesus Christ. Thank you for that wonderful salvation plan, Lord. No one could possibly do that except for you, Lord. You are such a magnificent and wonderful and loving God. Thank you, in Jesus' name, thank you.
Colossians 3:17 says, "And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him."
I invite you to stand as we sing together, "Worthy is the Lamb."
Yeah. 7, verse 1. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. 2 Corinthians 9, 15. Thanks be unto God for his unspeakable gift.
Our next song that we'll be offering up in praise will be Wonderful, Merciful Savior. Let's stand as we sing.
Thessalonians 13, but we are bound to give thanks always to God for you, brethren beloved of the Lord, because God hath from the beginning chosen you to salvation through sanctification of the Spirit and belief of truth.
In a few moments, Alex is going to come up and lead us in a prayer of thanks for our church. For our pastors, for our deacons, for our church workers that work even in unseen places. It all has to work together to worship God with excellence. Karen and I have just been here a few weeks, now a couple months, and we've grown to love and appreciate this church. We were in another church from 1971 until this July. We greatly miss those fellow believers, but you know what? You made it precious to us. You've welcomed us. We've seen the love of Christ. That's what it's about, folks. By this shall all men know that you are my disciples. By what? our love for one another. That's what we need to be concerned about. That's right, brother. Alex, could you come and just thank God and praise Him for what He has allowed to have people minister in our lives and for our church?
Let us pray. Father, can we just pause now and thank You for this, our church, that You and Your sovereign will placed right here in the heart of Elkton. How we thank You for that, Father. Father, how we thank You that the light of this church has reached into some of the darkest corners here in Elkton and abroad. But Father, we thank You for the ministries that have come out of this church that You've allowed us to have to reach out to others, that we, as Your precious Son, Jesus Christ, can serve others. Father, we thank You for the refuge that this church has become to each of us, that we can come here and get away from all the hustle and bustle of life and come in and get close to You. How we thank You and praise You for that. But Father, we have seen that the testimony of this church that we can thank You for has allowed others, even outside of this church, to come to this church because of that testimony in their times of sorrow and grief. And You, Father, we thank You that You have allowed us to minister to those people and show the love of Jesus Christ. Well, Father, we thank You for this church that without excuse proclaims the gospel of Jesus Christ, that sticks to the doctrine of Your word. And we thank You and praise You that You have allowed it to go on as You have. We praise You for that, for all the works of this church. We praise You. We praise You, Father, for our pastor. We thank You and praise You for Pastor Gary, that, Father, through thick and thin, he sticks to the Word of God, that he has a heart, Father, to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ, not only here in these pews, but, Father, through all the different media ministries that You have allowed this church to have. We thank You, Father, that even when it's not popular, He sticks to Your word. We thank You for a pastor that has taught us, Father, to look at all things through a biblical worldview, regardless of what society and the popular vote of the day is. We thank You, Father, that He has a heart for missions, to share that gospel, to allow that gospel to reach every corner of the world, Father. Some 28 different missionaries that we can thank and praise You for, that You have allowed, that You, Father, have sustained in this church. We thank You for him, for his ministries. We thank You that, Father, You, again, in Your sovereign will, have placed him here as the shepherd of this flock. We thank You, Father, that You have allowed him to be with us. We thank You for the love that he shows. We thank You, Father, for everything that You have allowed him to do here. And Father, how equally we thank You for Pastor Chaz, for their ministry here. We thank You, Father, for his love and burden for the youth and the young people. We thank You, Father, that he too stands firm upon the Word of God, that these young people, Father, are hearing the true Word of God, no compromise. How we thank You and praise You for that. In a day where so many are going belly up, we thank You that this church and our pastors stand firm upon the Word of God. We just praise You for that. Father, for these deacons, we thank You that You have raised them up to serve as Your Son Jesus Christ came to serve. We thank You, Father, for how they serve their flocks. We thank You for how they serve in their ministries. We thank You, Father, for the special needs and things that they are able to do through the strength and the resources that You and You alone have given them. We praise You for it, Father. We praise You for the willingness. We praise You, Father, for all that they're able to do as they seek to serve You and to please You and to honor You in all that they do. And Father, for the ministry workers, it's what makes it all come together. We thank You and praise You for them, for the time and the resources that they put in. We thank You, Father, that so many of these ministries, because of these workers, reach out to those, Father, some we will never know. whether it is through the children's ministries, Father, that we thank you for, that you allow us to bring them in and give them the Word of God, or the cafe, or the media ministries, or the transportation, all these ministries we thank you for. For those within the church, those that serve as ushers and in the teachings, and all the little jobs, Father, that we probably take for granted, we praise you for the steadfastness of these people. We just thank you and praise you, Father, that you allow us to function as a local church here, as a biblical New Testament local church. We praise you. We give you the honor and the praise for what you allow us to do. In the most precious name of Jesus, amen.
Psalm 28:7. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusted in him, and I am helped. Therefore, my heart greatly rejoiceth, and with my song will I praise him. Psalm 104. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name.
On the screen we have the little chorus, Let's Just Praise the Lord, and we certainly have a lot to praise the Lord for. We all have a lot to thank him for, and then because of all he's done, we can love him. Let's stand and sing the little chorus. Let's just praise the Lord. And let's sing it out like we really mean it. Praise him, thank him, and love him. All right? Sing it out now.
Let's just praise.
Unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hebrews 13:15. By him, therefore, let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually. That is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name.
Verses 5 and 6 of our psalm that we're looking at together. Verses 5 and 6. He hath given meat unto them that fear him. He will ever be mindful of his covenant. He hath showed his people the power of his works, that he may give them the heritage of the heathen. God, for the children of Israel, sustained them in the wilderness. He brought them out of the land. They had many things to thank God for and remember and praise God for. Did they often do it? Unfortunately, no. We have many things to thank God for, to praise God for. Do we do it? Do we do it? I've asked Josh to come here in just a moment and lead us in a prayer. for our nation. Thanks and a praise for our nation. And we have a lot to be thankful for. Josh Julius.
Let's have our word of prayer, shall we? Lord in heaven, we want to thank you, God, for the nation in which you have given us. The nation in which our forefathers have fought hard and worked hard to have the land of the free and the home of the brave. We want to thank you, God, that you are the ruler of this nation. We would thank you, God, for the fact that this nation has the right to have the life, the liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. It's all because of you. You have founded this nation for us. You have given this land for us. When the pilgrims first walked to this land, they had no idea what to do at first, but your guidance, your wisdom upon them, and your grace has blessed them so much, it would one day flourish the little colonies into the land which we call the United States of America. Lord, what better king who would rule this land than you, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? And we want to praise you, God, for giving us a bountiful, fruitful land, a land in which we have the right to preach the gospel, a land that was dedicated to go out and preach the gospel to the world, a land in which it has the Declaration of Independence. Father, we thank you, God, for the freedom which you've given to this nation. We thank you, God, for the rights. We thank you, God, that this nation was made in your name. In your name alone. A nation in which we can come and worship you. What other nation could freely do that than America? So, Lord, we praise you for what you have given us. We praise you for all you have done for us through the wars and the strifes in which our forefathers have fought through. We thank you, God. And we thank you for this gift of the nation. Because without this nation, Lord, where could we go to fulfill your will? And Lord, we just want to praise you, Father, for all these things. In Jesus' most awesome name, amen.
First Thessalonians 5:16-18. Rejoice evermore, pray without ceasing, and everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you.
I invite you to stand with me as we sing together, Jesus, we just want to thank you.
Jesus, you trust.
103, 2 through 5 says, Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, for whom forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies.
Psalm 111, verses 7 and 8. The works of his hand are verity and judgment, and all his commands are sure. They stand fast forever and ever, and are done in truth and uprightness. See, God's works are verity or truth and judgment or justice. God is always true and always just. All his commandments are sure, firm, to be compiled with, to be complied with. They are unchangeable. That's God's commandments. They stand fast forever and ever, and are done in truth and in equity or uprightness. See, his commands are established and will not fail and will not fall. We have a God that can do exceedingly, abundantly, above what? All that we could ever ask or think. That's our God. That's our God. We have so much to be thankful for. Just before Pastor Chasdall comes to lead us in a prayer of thanks for our blessings and lead us in a prayer for the offering that we're going to take, I'm going to ask Pastor Gary Dahl to come and give three announcements. I've been told you have some announcements that you need to have given. Okay? So this is the appropriate time to give those announcements.
I'm never too sure when it's the appropriate time to give announcements, but somebody told me years ago that announcements are the church ministry in action. And I think there's a lot of truth to that, the church ministry in action. And I was thinking as this service was going on, I do not know of how to interrupt the worshipful attitude of this service to give these announcements, but again, let's worship God and thank God even for what these announcements represent. So I want you to think of it in that sense. Some of you remember our dear friend Ken Dua, missionary with Way of Truth Ministries over in Ghana, Africa. Some of you also know of his son, Desmond. We talk about this sometimes in various services. And Desmond has a lot of physical and emotional needs. Over in Africa, they don't have Obamacare, good or bad, I suppose, as however you want to interpret that. But it's very, very difficult for them to get medical care over there. It cost Ken Dua $1,000 a month to keep Desmond in the hospital, and he's got to be in there to get the medical treatment that he needs to keep him settled down and so forth and so on. Now, you know, I suppose if we were to say, we spent $1,000 in the hospital for a month, that'd be cheap on our side. But over there, that's extremely expensive. Just this morning, Ken got word that he could go and pick up Desmond and bring him home. But Ken does not have the funds to pay the hospital. And so you calculate it, it's about $30 a day. And again, to us, that might not be so much. But over there, for Brother Ken Dua, who, by the way, is the director of our Way of Truth Ministries Baptist Mission over there, that's a lot. He's got to make arrangements with the hospital before he can release his son, take him home. I want to give us an opportunity tonight to help Brother Ken stand with his son, Desmond. You know, their ministry over there, Ken's ministry is beyond compare. They have, he has started 17 churches himself in Ghana. But through his ministry, Way of Truth is also in Togo as well as in Liberia. A great, great man of God who has a great big need now. Way of Truth Ministries covers the medical expenses for all of the Way of Truth missionaries. And so I would like to ask you to pray about giving to this matter. If you would like to, in a moment when we take up the offering, please feel free to do it. You can make a check out to the church, but put on there for Desmond. Or if you want to put some cash in an envelope, say Desmond. But this, he needs help. And if I can contact Ken DeMar and say we're making arrangements to supply the need, he'll be able to take Desmond home. Until that happens, he can't. And it's just going to build up in the amount. So please pray about that, and maybe tonight you can give. I know you didn't come planning on giving, but part of Thanksgiving is giving. And so this might have been the first time you heard it, so perhaps even in anticipation of Sunday you can consider this. We'd appreciate it very, very much. Then also, I want to ask for your help in another way. And I was just thinking about this as it relates to giving your thanks. As you know, we have Stand in the Gap Radio that's on nearly 500 stations every day across the nation. And this coming Friday, I'm going to be doing it myself because Dave and Sam cannot be with us. And I'm thinking, in light of everything that's going on in the world today, we ought to be thankful for the United States of America for many, many reasons. And what I'm going to do on Friday on the radio program is talk about giving thanks to God for America and asking people to call in and express that thanks. I want to give you the opportunity to do that, and I would ask you to help me in doing that. We never know when we open the phone lines what's going to happen, if you could even get through, or maybe you can't get through, or you can get through. But I would like, if you would not mind, to stand with me in giving thanks for a nation. I'd love to see, even though it won't be announced, I'd love to see people from our church take the lead in this across the nation on Friday. Now, if you listen to Stand in the Gap here, you know it's not on until when? 7 o'clock at night. But you can listen to it online, and that is at standinthegapradio.com. Simply standinthegapradio.com. You can listen to it live online, standinthegapradio.com. And I would encourage you to do that on Friday and call in and express thanks why you are thankful to live in the United States of America. I'm not going to give you the phone number because the phone number is given over the air. But to listen to it online, you go to standinthegapradio.com, and all you'll need to do is call in, and you'll give them your name, and they'll tell me what your name is over the computer screen. And I'll just say, Micah, what are you thanking the Lord for? Something along that line. So would you be willing to work with me on that? And that's from 12 until 1 on Friday afternoon. And the site where you can go to listen to the program online is standinthegapradio.com. One other thing to give thanks for is decorating the church for Christmas. And we're going to be having the opportunity to put the decorations up for the church this coming Friday. And any questions that you have on that, please see Danielle Jagel. But we have a lot to be thankful for. And I see back there Pat and Megan Walk. Would you three come up here, please? I said you three, so Zeke, bring them on up here. I've got to tell you that it's such a joy to have them with us tonight. But I also want to say, Pat and Megan have been example parents to me. I'm an old, worn-out parent. Well, you didn't have to agree, but I am. But the way that Pat and Megan has stood out there at that hospital in Pittsburgh taking care of Zeke is exemplary of the way Christ takes care of us. And yeah, let's go ahead. Give your stand of ovation. And you know, I asked, you may be seated, I asked Megan one day to write down specifically what Zeke's issues were so that I could pray for them. And the language of those terms were beyond my ability to pronounce, so I just said, God, here's what his problem is. I pray for him. But he's coming along. They've already dedicated to the Lord, and one of these days we'll do that publicly. But this is the little Zeke. Now, this is the little Zeke we've been praying for. Look at him. And I'm telling you, God's going to use him in ways beyond our imagination to the glory of God. And, you know, Megan is a sweet young lady and does great things. But Pat is something else. But yesterday I was out there, I don't know if you knew that, Megan, but I was out there when it came feeding time. And just to watch Pat mix all of those things together in the little thingamajig and shake it up, and I'm impressed.
A little bit of practice.
But I've got to say, right here before us tonight, not only are two young people in our congregation, but two young people who are examples of Jesus Christ. I want to thank you for the example you set for me in being the kind of a loving father and mother. We need more of you. And whether you know it or not, you've written the book for us to follow. Thank you. God bless you. And we're going to pray for this guy. And one of these days, he's going to turn the world upside down. Little Ezekiel. And you know something? His name's Ezekiel. Where else do you find an Ezekiel? In the Bible. Pat and Megan have been studying the book of Ezekiel together as they've been out there in the hospital. They've grown spiritually, even though they've been away from us, because they've been studying the Word of God together. The prophet named after which this guy was named. I did get to hold him once out of the basket. I'm going to be careful in this basket because I almost dropped the baby up here one day and was in the basket. But look at him. You pray for him, okay? And Father, tonight, we just thank you for Pat and Megan and the way that you've worked in their lives, giving them this little precious life. He is a little precious life. And Lord, he's a gift to us from you. And Father, I just thank you for what you've done in his life, for the way that you've worked through Pat and Megan, and for the way that you're going to continue to work. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Try to keep in touch with them, not quite every day, but several times throughout the course of the week. And last week, Megan, I don't know if you know if Pat said this or not, but I asked how he's doing, and his response was, he's just having a great time, and he can't wait till his quiver gets full of them. So, are you quivering? You remember saying that, Pat?
Yeah,
you said that. So, tonight, here is a visible reason to give thanks to God for what he's done. Amen? God bless you. Amen.
Pastor Chaz is going to come and he's going to lead us in a prayer of thanks, for the blessings that God has placed in our lives. Blessings like that blessing and many other blessings. And after that, we're going to have the offering and we give unto the Lord. Pastor Chaz is going to pray also for the offering. And then Lisa's going to play a song. The words are going to be up here. Probably a song you haven't heard before. But watch the words and let them bless your hearts. Pastor Chaz.
Well, the men come forward and then go ahead and pray.
pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we do thank you for the many blessings in our lives. Lord, as we sing the song, we should count them one by one, but Lord, as we sing the other song, the showers of blessings, there's so many. What if we were counting one by one? Well, we'd be here longer than probably when you'd come back. And Lord, we thank you for the many blessings that you do shower upon us. Lord, the blessings of your love, your sending of your Son to die on the cross for us. And then, if we come to know your Savior, everything we received after that is beyond what we can even imagine, Lord. Lord, I thank you for that. Lord, I thank you for this opportunity we have to give back to you. Lord, help us to show you with our heart, as we open our wallets, how much we love and thank you for the blessings that we have. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Psalm 9, 1 and 2. I will praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will show forth all thy marvelous works. I will be glad and rejoice in thee. I will sing praise to thy name, O thou most high.
Morning, noon, and night, we receive the blessings from the Lord, and they are great day by day, 365 days a year. Let's stand and sing that great song, Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. We know it as doxology. You don't need to turn the page. It's 197, but we all know that. Praise God for what he has done. Ready?
Praise God, blessings flow.
My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord, and let all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever. Psalm 146, verse 2. While I live, I will praise the Lord. I will sing praises unto my God while I have any being.
Psalm 111, verse 9 says, And he sent redemption unto his people. He hath commanded his covenant forever. Holy and reverend is his name. That word reverend, holy and awesome is his name. Literally meaning to be feared, as he leads into verse 10 that we'll look at in just a moment. At this time, we're going to have Ron, come and lead us in a prayer of thanks for trials and suffering. You know, it's real easy to praise God for and thank God for the blessings. But you know what? Sometimes he allows trials and suffering in our lives. And you've experienced it. God has a purpose in it. God hasn't forgotten you. God hasn't abandoned you. We can praise him for even the trials. And yeah, even sometimes the suffering that comes into our lives. Can we do that? Or do we want all just the rosy road? Ron, come and lead us in prayer for that request.
Father, as we humbly come before you this evening, just that name that we may call you Father means a loving kindness that we can actually cry out, Abba, Father. And Father, we know that as we enter through and through this world that we do run into trials. Father, we do run into temptations. Father, we bear sufferings, but it's so good that, Father, that we have your word that tells us that you won't leave us forsaken. That, Father, your son had to return to you, but he would leave us comfortless, but he would send another comforter, that Holy Ghost. That, Father, that as we come into these trials, that, Father, we might have joy through these trials and temptations, Father, because it's drawn us closer to you. Father, we learn through these trials to be dependent, to trust in only you. For only you can help us. Father, as sometimes the sorrow is overwhelming and the tears may fall as river, but Father, we know in whom we believe. We know in whom we trust. We thank you at this time that we have your word, that Father would lead us to know you, know what you expect from us. And you would just even show us how you're going to work. That we may find that comfort and solace in your word in these times of testing. And Father, we also have the word that tells us that they are only like a vapor. They're not worth to be compared to what you have in store for us. That someday, Father, that we look back on these trials and testings, we know that it was for our good that these patients worked us to perfection. Father, that we may someday be with you and see that it was worth it all. As we praise you, let us praise you wholeheartedly tonight, Father, for who you are, for the word that you've given to us. And we'll do it in the precious name of our Savior, another gift from you, in Jesus Christ.
Psalm 86, verses 12 and 13 say this: I will praise thee, O Lord my God, with all my heart, and I will glorify thy name forever. For great is thy mercy toward me, and thou hast delivered my soul from the lowest hell. And then Psalm 104, verses 33 and 34 say this: I will sing unto the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praise to my God while I have my being. My meditation of him shall be sweet. I will be glad in the Lord.
I invite you to stand with me as we sing my tribute. To God be the glory for the things he has done.
Says the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Literally, in view of God's great acts, God's great faithfulness, fearing him is the better part of wisdom. That's what it's all about. A good understanding have all they that do his commandments. His praise endureth forever. Unending, unchangeable praise. That's what God desires. And that's what we owe him. Because because he loved us long before we loved him. Oh, we have a precious God. We have a precious Savior. And I've heard you sing about him as a congregation. I've heard his word uplifted in our ears. I've heard prayers of thanks and praise. And I trust it's blessed your heart. I trust that we'll look at tomorrow different than we would have looked at tomorrow. That Thanksgiving will just not be about turkey, as good as it is. Or stuffing, as Pastor Chaz would say. Or mashed potatoes, right, Gorman? It's not all about that. That's just some of his goodness. Oh, God is so good. Let's pray together as we close in a prayer of thanks for the privilege of worshiping him. And then we're going to ask our parish officer to come again and pick up the word of God. Lift it high and walk out. And as that word of God passes you, I want you to stand in reverence to our great God for the word of God, which tells us about his greatness. For he is our all in all. Is he not? Let's pray. Father, thank you for the privilege of corporately worshiping you, of singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, of hearing from your word, of praying to you and praising you for all that you've done. And Father, we haven't even come close to scratching the surface. Help us to marvel in your greatness. That Thanksgiving Day will be a time of thankfulness and praise for the wonderful God that you are. Thank you. Thank you so much for the privilege of worshiping you together. In Jesus' name.